Alrighty, I think it's recording, so here I am with another video. It's kind of surprising. I'm very surprised that my one video about body types and color seasons and stuff like that got as many views as it has. So I'm not sure if it's just because of the topic, which I really think it's more or less the topic, because finding those guide, in-depth guide really, in towards trying to find something that fits your body or get it inspired by is kind of hard, especially like when I was looking, I didn't really find a lot of dramatic classics or this color will particularly go into your season or something like that or whatnot. It was kind of general, it was kind of brief, and I didn't really expect it to get as much views or as much attention as it is. Like, I didn't really strive for that much attention, really. I just thought it was just gonna be kind of, you know what, it's a fun idea. Something a little different than tarot readings and stuff like that. And, like, this channel is really just kind of, not really, like, I don't really, you know, create content for views or have things planned, like, oh, this will get this many views, or this will get this many likes on the video, or this shares, or blah, 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 blah. I think a bunny's inside my sister's room, but it's not like I expected anything really to come, you know, out of this channel, just kind of besides just me talking and just giving advice when I can, or kind of what's the word, just relaying my thoughts and stuff like that. I didn't really think that it was going to get as much views as it did or as much attention as it did, but it has, and I'm thankful for it. You know, I'm thankful that, you know, whether it just be the topic or just kind of clicking, just, you know, hear me babble on and very low camera quality and that kind of stuff, it's just, it's eye-opening. Of course, my videos have gotten a lot better now that I've been using my my Blue Yeti mic. Maybe get some more money invested into like some decent camera that I could hook up here and just kind of record that way. But I don't know, like, as if now, you know, it's just kind of like I make these videos just for more or less fun, just kind of, you know, I don't really have some sort of motive or attention or some sort of underlying reason why I post this stuff. I just post when I, you know, when I really feel like it and stuff like that. And it's just, it's mind-boggling to me, you know, how much views you know, just gotten on that. And I didn't think whether it just be, you know, for giggles or just actually if you learn something or you just like to watch it, it's all up to you what you want to do. I'm very happy, you know, that you just take the time to click and look at it, you know, and I don't expect each, you know, video to get 300 views. I don't expect a video to get, like, one view. But even if it's just the one view or 300 views, then I'm happy, you know. I'm happy that I at least entertained or at least brought forth some knowledge to somebody. Whether or not what I want to do in the future, I've been kind of thinking about it, you know, now that I have, like, thoughts and ideas in my head, like, oh, well, this video went well, so what if I tried doing this or tried doing that? And obviously I'm no expert. I'm not here to tell you what to do or how to live your life or how to dress, how to act, how to do anything in your life, because it's your life. But maybe give some advice here and there, you know, for tarot readings or whatever you want to wear. I'll do that, you know. I'm just glad that, you know, you're here and you click the video, you know, and I'm glad that, you know, because some people, you know, even just that one person, you know, just watching it, you know, maybe still watching, I don't know, but I'm thankful that you're here, and I'm just thankful in general. Now, I'm a little bit tired. That's only because I had a long work day, because I work 8:30 to 6. Granted, I don't work on weekends or a Wednesday. That's great, but does not mean that I'm very tired. But I want to make a quick video because tomorrow I'll probably be sleeping in and doing some stuff, and I wanted to do a video for the weekend. I'm gonna take my ring off just because this has been kind of bothering me. As you can see, I work with files and stuff like that, so usually my hands are covered in paper cuts now, and I've had to keep my nails short ever since I started working there a few weeks ago. Before at my old job, when I worked from home, I used to paint my nails all the time and stuff like that, and grow them out long, cut them short, or just do my nails at home in general. Like, I'd have time if I had a break during a call, or if I had a little bit of time during anything, just to do my nails real quick, or to, because I didn't have to do a lot of heavy lifting or heavy stuff. All I did was just sit at a computer all day and type and take calls and, excuse me, and just do kind of, you know, stuff from home. Like, I didn't really have to do anything much work-wise. Now I lift stuff. I mostly deal with paperwork, so having good nails is kind of hard when they're all chipped and getting chipped because of papers and stuff and old files. So it's kind of like, I mean, I was really upset. That's why I've been cutting them short recently, just to kind of keep them at bay. But I just stopped painting them this week, I think. Just because, you know, it's a pain in the poop blah when you have to keep doing your manicure over and over again just because it started to chip and stuff like that. And of course I paint, you know, clear coat and, you know, put some oils on my nails and my hands to help with the paper cuts, because I get them on the daily. Like, I get paper cuts, no joke, on the daily. Like, I have a paper cut right here on my pinky, right there, right by the nail. And of course, whenever I press or pick something up, I brush the paper cut against something and I can feel it, and it feels weird. I have a paper cut right here, like right on the, so when I bend my finger, I can feel it. I had one right here on the side of the nail. I've been wearing gloves now at work, just to kind of protect from the paper cuts and stuff like that. But sometimes I'll have to take them off because the gloves, when you're writing, it's kind of hard to write with the gloves on. So it's kind of like, this is how you know I did work this week. I have band-aids and paper cuts all over my fingers. But I keep a water. That was a bunny. But I keep moisturizer and, you know, cream for my hands at all times. That's why my hands are so baby soft. Just to kind of, you know, take care of them and, you know, keep them moisturized and stuff. Because it's easier to do so. And plus you're dealing with dry files and dry paper all day. And cardboard. So it dries out your hands. It really does. So I. But reminds me, I kind of need to redo my toenails, because I also do those too. I need to repaint my nails, just because it's getting time when they need to be painted again. But yeah, anyways, what was I talking about? Videos. So yeah, I do have some few ideas, actually, of what I wanted to do and kind of plan it out, and just this time kind of plan a little bit and stuff, and maybe play a little bit more with editing, because I'm also a musician, so I do videos and stuff like that on the side for my own channel and stuff like that. And I edit the videos, except the one video. The one video, someone else edited it for me and did the whole thing and shot it, which I'm very thankful for. Thank you, Vinny. But shout out to Vinny. But other than that, you know, I'm like, I don't mind editing those, but like for these, I'm just kind of like, I'm lazy, I don't want to edit. I'll just post a video online. It's not like I have anything fancy or fancy graphics, because like I said, you know, I'm not really making these to appeal to anyone or to make someone like pop out and be like, hey, this is pretty fucking cool, you know. It's just videos, you know, mic, me, camera, talking to the wall, talking to a bunny, talking to myself, which is a usual occurrence, but yeah, that's basically it, you know? But even though I got paper cuts, I'm still gonna wear my little wings. I can't wear big rings, which is really upsetting, I can't wear rings at all, but I got my wingies on. That's why probably this one's been bothering me. What do you want, Tetra? That's what I thought, cutie bun. Maybe if you come in, maybe I could show you off, cutie bun. He'll be back, and I'll pick him up, and I'll be like, Kitter! But, yeah. So we got that. What else did I want to say? Sorry, I'm just real tired. Probably after this, I'll go to bed, but then wake up in, like, 10 minutes and be like, ooh, let's see what's on TV, and watch TV. Or, ooh, let's see what's on Netflix, or on a podcast, or YouTube scrolling, or what do I have to do on my little... Because my one buddy of mine gave me a Kindle tablet. And they have like a little section for books, so I've been down, like there's some books already on there that I've been reading. So sometimes I'll do that, just because, you know, it's easier to have an electronic book than it is a paper book, just because of storage, but always buy the print. Print is not dead. I don't care what you say, print is not dead. But, yas. What else do I want to say? You think I'd write something down just to say something, but no. That's not how I work today. That's not how my function is today. Tether! Come here, baby. Tether, me boy. Come here. Come here, me boy. I got you. This is Tether. Tether. Boy. And maybe you just watch it just because you like rabbit stuff. What a cute bun bun. Look at him contemplating his life choices now. Sometimes he hates it when I pick him up. Let's go belly whips. See, he gets angsty. I'll put you down, but only if you say one thing. Perfect. Can't kiss your neck? Can I kiss your nose? Oh, thank you for letting me kiss your neck. So tasty. Ready? You're gonna hate me for this, but I'm gonna do it anyway. So tasty. You taste good. So scrumptious. So sweet. Yummies. Look at the rabbit feet. Look at the rabbit feet. I gotta kiss the tootsies. Kiss the paws. Kiss the nosey. Kiss the butt. And the eyes. Now the butt. Now the tum-tum. One ear. Two ears. Behind of the ears. And then he gets so flustered. He's like, why would you kiss me? Why would you give me attention? I'm embarrassed. Too damn bad. Mommy thinks you're a cutie, that's why. But he comes back. Ready? I'm gonna put you down. He's looking at me like, he got down and then he looked right back at me like that, like all angry, like, why would you do that? It's because I love you, Chester. God, fuck damn. Love you, baby boy. Just want to show you my lovin's. My baby boy. Now I got rabbit fur on my face. It was totally worth it, though. And on my band-aids. And in my mouth. Okay. Totally worth it. Oh, you know what? I have no agenda. We're already 15 minutes into this. I figured, let's talk. And by talk, I mean talking to the microphone and talk to the camera. But, even though I may not be talking, even though I may not be sitting in front of you, talking to you, but I do hope that maybe things that I say, or things that I talk about, will maybe spark your interest and make you feel like you could also have a conversation. When I think of the video, the 300 views and stuff like that, I just think it's crazy. It seems like life has been really crazy for me. I'm sure like everybody has crazy times, crazy years, a crazy day, but it's been crazy, you know? I've done a lot more things that I ever thought I could possibly do. I'm trying to hold back a yawn. In this whole year. And not going to lie, it's been quite tough. Sometimes thinking about it, because there's been like lots of setbacks, a lots of drawbacks, a lot of hard times, a lot of, you know, hopeless times even. But there's been a lot of good times, you know, there's been a lot of happier times. And now as I get towards the end of the year, it's crazy. It's crazy how much, and even though you're probably thinking, it's only November, like, Jesus, Nikki, it's not even December yet. But, a lot has happened. Like, a lot of people don't realize how much things happen in a year. You know? For some, it's eventful, and for others, it's just calm. Or nothing special. But, for me, it's been different, you know. I started off 2023 not feeling too excited, but not feeling too hopeful either, you know. You know, I remember going to see a psychic December of last year, and some stuff she said that she predicted was true, and others didn't really, you know, happen. But, and she's like, if I'm not accurate, like, if I'm not at least 70% accurate, then, you know. I'd say she's accurate on some things, but she was not accurate on a lot of things. But, yeah. It's just, when I started off and, you know, her readings and everything like that. Her reading, I only went to her once. That was only because people were telling me to go to her. And she's a very nice lady, and it's just very interesting how much we want to know about the future, how much we want to know, have set in stone. Like, we're just, as human beings, we're just so natural and curious about things. We're so wanting more. We're never satisfied with not knowing, or things in general. You know, we always want, but we never ask, what do we need? Or what is a necessity? And usually when people think of, well, what do you need? You know, the first thing people say is, oh, well, I need gas for my car. Or I need this or that. We don't really think of emotional needs. Security needs. And I'm not saying like a roof over your head or clothes on your back. And obviously those are very important and a necessity. You know, that's something that I thought of this year quite a bit. But, like, emotional needs. Like, what do I want out of the future? What do I think I need at this moment to help me towards my goals? Do I need a boyfriend? Do I need a girlfriend? Do I need a partner? Do I want a good friend? Do I want to better myself mentally? Do I want to take care of myself? Start, you know, where is it? Start planning out my days. My planner. Start making goals for myself. What do I need? Do I need someone to tell me that it's gonna be okay? Do I need someone to sit down and listen to my talks? You know, it's opened my eyes that we never really ask ourselves, what emotional needs do we need, you know? When people say, hey, what do you need? You think of a materialistic item, or you think of a problem or issue that you want to be solved. You don't think of the people you need. The security, emotional security, the mental happiness that you need in order to kick on, you know? Because some people can have everything. They could have $1 million, like, each fucking year and just be rich and live off of that. And, you know, buy your fucking Ferraris and live in fucking mansions your whole life and have, like, dollar bills coming out of your ass crack. But, you have all of that. But you don't have... You're not as rich as the average person, you know? That may not have a lot of money. May not have a fancy Ferrari. Maybe even drive a Honda. But they consider themselves rich. Because every night, every day they go home to people they love, or they call the people they love, and they feel like the richest among them. We really don't ask ourselves that, or even think about that. We usually only think of what we need physically, but never what do we need to help us get through the day? What do we need to help us get through hard times? And we always depend on other people. One thing that I've noticed this year, and I'll get into this one, is also to dependence, you know? I find this year have been quite crazy for me. I went from being on my own without living, you know, not living with a parent, or living with roommates, or, you know, living with the boyfriend or whatnot, you know, the majority of this year, I was on my own. I lived by myself. And it was freeing at times. God damn, it was freeing. I didn't have to worry about this person bitching because I was up late, or this person bitching about my bunnies running around. Which obviously nobody's done that yet, but I'm just saying, you know, because I got my bunnies when I lived by myself. But I didn't have that. I didn't have to worry about those things for the majority of my time. I didn't have to worry about that for the majority of the year. And it was crazy. It was freeing, but it was crazy. And obviously, I really did like living alone. I didn't mind. I never felt lonely, even without the pets. You know, I only really wanted to get a bunny because I wanted it off my bucket list to get a pet. And my landlord was like, oh, you know, you can't have a cat or a dog. So, you have a rabbit, because I asked about a rabbit. When I was a little kid, I've always wanted to have a bunny. But, you know, now I'm 23 years old, and now I have 3 bunnies. 3 little baby buns. Running around and stuff. But I remember, like, towards July. I remember towards June. I remember even August. You know, crying a lot, because we get so hung up on the things that we don't have. I felt like I was going nowhere during that time in life. You know, I felt like a failure in some ways, because I didn't feel like I was at that stage that I wanted to be in life at 23. Because that's the thing, you plan out your life, and when it doesn't happen the way you want it to, you get so disappointed and so angry at yourself for not it being the way you want it to be. And that's just human nature. I think if anything that I want you to take away from that, what I just said, is that be angry. Be sad. Be fearful. And love every minute of it. And I only say that is because going through those emotions helps you process it, helps you heal from it, helps you learn from it, grow from it even. And you take that with you. And that's something that I did. It hurt a lot, you know. It hurt being September and having to find out, oh, well, I don't know where the fuck am I gonna be. So I've been looking at apartments and stuff like that and all that kind of stuff, and I don't want to live with a roommate and blah, 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 and I was shit out of luck. Then I moved back here. And I may not be able to say, hey, yeah, you know, I live by myself now. I am independent now. I have bunnies running around everywhere. I'm an adult. And that used to make me feel so happy. Because it's all I ever wanted. And then it was taken away from me and all that kind of stuff. And slumlord. That was the biggest thing, a slumlord. But once it was taken away from me, I remember, you know, I cried. I was depressed for a little bit, you know. You know, I'd sleep on the couch because, you know, that's where I'd sleep. And I just think to myself, wow, I'm back at my dad's house, sleeping on his couch at 23. There's gotta be something wrong with me. You know, and some people would be like, oh my god, 23, that's like you're just a fucking baby then, but I don't know, like, many people say, oh, well, you're an adult, and many people say that you're young, but it's all the standard, really, that you hold yourself up to. Because we hold up ourselves to so many standards that we don't even realize it. That we should be this way. That we should, after college or whatnot, we should have this high-paying 9-to-5 job, you know, weekends off and making a shit ton of money and living life. And then save up and be living in an apartment and buy a fucking house, you know, or save up for your own fucking place or be on your own. And we think that. We hold ourselves up to that standard. And that's what I did for quite a while. And even just now, just realizing that I can't keep holding myself up to a standard, that you shouldn't hold yourself up to a standard or feel any worse for being in the predicament that you are in currently. You know? You don't have to have it all to feel happy or feel independent or feel complete. You know? And don't ever think that there's something wrong with you just because you're not there yet. That's something that I really blamed myself for a while. I remember, because I worked from home, so I remember in July not having any money because I was fucking paying off so many fucking loans and debt and all that kind of stuff for college and everything, so I didn't have to worry about it later on in life. But I remember, like, crying myself to sleep because I look at my bank account and I'd be like, wow, it's negative 30. It's amazing that I still live on my own and not have to worry about that. It's amazing that I have a job that I can work from home with, but I'm not happy. I remember crying myself to sleep thinking that, you know, I never felt more alone at that moment. Another thing too is love. You know, this has been on my mind recently quite a bit. You know, we all dream of finding that perfect someone. We all dream of finding someone to understand us. And I think for me, the biggest thing that I've been learning over and over and over again, especially now, is that I'm happy with myself. I'm happy being myself. I'm happy by myself. I'm happy with myself. You know? You tell in your mind constantly that you need to have some sort of relationship or validation from somebody to feel like you're on top of the world. Excuse me, I was just yawning. But, you know, and I've only been single for like what? Almost like a year and about 6 months. Not even 2 years yet. And I've learned a lot during that time. You know, and you don't have to feel like you need someone to feel complete. And obviously, it doesn't mean that I'm just giving up and stuff like that. I remember just recently, learning this lesson, we try so hard to find somebody right then and there. So that way we never feel alone. That way we feel complete with someone or because of someone. And like I remember like just thinking that I don't need someone to feel good or feel like I'm complete in some way. You know, like people go on dating apps or they go on speed dating or they date random people or go back even to their exes just because of the fact they feel like they're nothing without them. Or they don't want to be feeling like they just don't want to be alone. But I feel like there's a lot more comfort in being alone, you know? I had like one of my friends that was like so lovesick and crying over love and stuff and just crying and crying and crying, and then they're like, here, you know, I downloaded what was it? It wasn't Tinder, because Tinder's Tinder. I think it was like Bumble or something like that. I think it was Bumble actually. They're like, here, I created a profile for you, here you go. I remember standing and staring at my phone, and you'd see these random people messaging you, oh, you're pretty, or oh, this, or oh, that, and you just feel, like, for me, it didn't make me feel right, you know, it didn't make me feel natural, you know, I'm unhappy, yeah, but do I need a relationship to fill that unhappy void? Do I need that? I can say now, no, I don't. And I remember just sitting there staring and watching my phone blow up and just not feeling right about it. You know, we try so hard to seek validation from other people and seek that kind of romantic comfort. Whether it's because we're lonely or we're trying to get over somebody. Just because we can't handle being alone. We can't handle being alone. Or being by ourselves. Or being with ourselves. That we'll do anything just to feel like there's nothing wrong with us, you know? It's probably a little going into too personal, but it's okay. Sharing is sharing. But I remember, you know, I remember being in a committed relationship a while ago, and we wore matching rings and stuff. We were called, proposed, even though it was really messy and stuff like that. It was still, you know, proposal and stuff. And I remember like going through stores and just looking at stuff, and I remember trying on this one really pretty white dress. It was very pretty white lace, strapless. It reminded me of like this 50s tea length style. And I remember putting it on, and I remember crying. And it wasn't because I was happy. I felt like there was something wrong with me. I felt out of place. And I remember crying. I remember talking to my mom about it and asking her, like, I feel like there's something wrong with me. You know, with somebody, without somebody, even just with somebody. I just, right now, at a moment that I feel like I should be the happiest, I feel like there's something wrong with me. And I remember my mom, she's just like, there's nothing wrong with you. There's nothing wrong with you, sweetie. And you hear that millions of times. You hear that from so many people, but when they finally say it, at the moment you think that you need it most, it just makes so much sense. And it helps so much than you ever thought possible. There's nothing wrong with you. Feeling like you're not ready. Feeling like anything. There's nothing wrong with you. And that's what I thought for a while. I really thought that there was something wrong with me for a while. Whether it be with people, relationships, or anything like that. And it took me 23 years of my life to realize there's nothing wrong with me. There really isn't. Sure, maybe I have a few screws, you know, missing, or sure, maybe I am a bit wild or a bit out there at times, but that's not a crime. You know, there's nothing wrong with me. And the moment you keep thinking that there's something wrong with you, ask yourself, what makes you feel like there's something wrong with you? And it wasn't just for me, relationships. Like, this year has been wild and crazy that I felt like I just had bad luck, or there's something always going to be wrong in my life. But life is just life. You know, you keep living, you keep moving, you keep breathing over and over and over again. And not because you have to. You realize when you finally come to that place of there's nothing wrong with me, of that independent place, that happy place, your own happy place, you realize. Hi, Chester. There's really nothing wrong with you. There's really nothing. And you're okay. You're alright. Right, Chester? Right, buddy boy? Hi, love bug. Hi. You sniffing mommy's feet? No. Little butt. And there's nothing wrong with waiting in love either. No, buddy. You know, wait for the right one. Wait for the one that makes you happy. You know, I remember deleting Bumble and just feeling so... I've only had it for like a few days, but I remember feeling just so liberated because I don't need someone to make me feel complete or feel like there is something good going on in my life. You know? And I remember I was texting one of my friends because they were, you know, going on about their ex and feeling down about relationships and stuff like that. And I remember texting him this. And he was going on talking about his ex and stuff like that and just feeling like he'll never find the right relationship or feeling like he'll never find the relationship. And when I said that, because sometimes you say things and you don't really take it into consideration until you actually say it and think about what you say. Hold on. I can hear Chester running around in there. Is it really funny? I think I'm getting into this. Yeah. There's this one where I was like, sometimes it sucks, but just because something is lost or over doesn't mean that love in any form doesn't exist. I think about it, and that kind of hope keeps me going. And the one thing that I really said that made me kind of really think about it same here. I've been focusing a lot more on myself and building back and building towards independence. Still, while I used to scoff at the thought of being with someone, it is not necessarily a relationship that is a problem, but the person that you are with. I'm in no rush, and if the time is right and I feel like that person is right, then it will be worthwhile. And I feel like you should never lose yourself in a relationship and never lose faith in people when you're out of one. Of course I'm gonna wait for that right person. Is it going to be long? Yeah. But it's love, you know? And just for anyone, you know, just because you're not in a relationship doesn't mean you have to lose faith in people just because you're not in one. Because heartbreak is a terrible thing. Heartbreak is heartbreaking. You know, that's why it's heartbreak. And it can make you feel all out of place. And then you try to convince yourself that you're the issue, that you're the problem, when a relationship that you're in, you feel is not going well. You try to tell yourself over and over and over again that there's something wrong with you and that the relationship that you're in is perfect. Why are you screwing it up, or why are you messing things up? Like, what's wrong with you? Like, you feel like you're the issue, you're the problem, you're screwing everything up in that relationship. But sometimes, even if it may seem like the most perfect relationship in general, it's just not the right one. And you shouldn't have to convince yourself that it is the right one, just either for the sake of not hurting their feelings, or just because you want to deny yourself in feeling that, or just because you don't want to be alone, you know? There's no sense or no feeling in general that you should feel like there's something wrong with you just because things are going right in a relationship. Or people are telling you that. Because oftentimes people tell us, like, why do you feel that way? I don't know, I just feel like it's not the right person or the right one. You shouldn't have to convince yourself otherwise. If you already know in your heart how you feel, you shouldn't have to convince yourself otherwise. And, like, for me, if I'm gonna be alone for a long period of time and be myself, be single, whatever, then I'm okay with that. You know, I got people around me. I got people who love me and tell me at the end of the day that I'm worthwhile. And not just because I want them to. It's just out of random, you know? You do things over and over and over again, and you try to help people, and it makes you feel good at the end of the day. Why? Because it makes you feel not just of use, but them Like, the feeling of them with their weight lifted off their shoulders, it just makes them feel so much with that and so much more happier that someone listens to them or someone appreciates them, values them enough to listen. And I'm sure maybe I'm just talking to the wall, but even if it's just that one person who watches this video or whatnot, not only do I have to say thank you for watching, but if I could get you to talk to someone, if I could just get you to listen to someone, just to say something, to listen, then that's all I could really want. Just to give you that power, that mode of confidence, to be able to speak your mind, speak it clearly, speak it from the heart, and listen to others. That's all I really want. Makes me happy doing that. It really does. And it also makes me happy realizing, too, that I don't need someone to feel validated or feel like I have to be dependent on, you know? And I'll gladly wait for that person. I gladly will. But doesn't mean I'm expecting it. Doesn't mean I need to hope for it forever and make it that one thing in my life. Live life, love life. And when they come, they'll come. And that's the biggest thing that I really have to give about that, you know? You know, love is messy, love is crazy. And you could love someone and let it consume your whole being, but never let it consume your individuality. You know, be yourself. But also love someone like you love yourself. Show them that appreciation. Show them that love and appreciation back that you give yourself too in return. Because at the end of the day, all we really want in life is to feel secure, to feel happy, to feel accomplished, but to also feel like there's meaning and there's hope in it. Because that's all we really want in life, is something to live for, something to hope for. That's what keeps us going. If I really think about it, my bunnies at the end of the day. Hoping that random guy texts me or messages me or DMs me, but can't make it like my whole life story. If it's right, it's right. And he'll come to me, then he'll come to me. As of now, I'm just waiting. That doesn't mean I'm going to be waiting my whole life away. I'm going to live life. I'm going to wait. And I'm going to appreciate the journey. Well, that's pretty cheesy. I don't know if it helped or inspired anybody. But it's something that I've learned recently and something that I've been wanting to say and just get off my chest. Maybe it's just the tired ramblings or whatnot, but that's all I gotta say. And it's like 49 minutes of just me talking and stuff. It's like going for 10 o'clock. I'm just gonna end it right there. And don't let other people try to bring you down or make you feel as if any less. And I always want you to have a conversation, to talk to someone, to keep the conversation going, whether it be down in comments, down in messages of people, or just saying stuff in general. I just rather you keep talking and you keep listening to anyone around you and even to yourself. Don't forget to listen and talk to yourself in the least creepiest way possible. But really take care of yourself and love yourself like you love other people. Because I tend to think that we're our own worst critic the most. We tend to criticize ourselves more than we criticize the average person. That's just me, though. So yeah, I'm a little tired. I'm very tired, actually. I think I'm gonna fall asleep at any moment. But I feel accomplished right now. I feel like I said what I wanted to say, and I think I'm gonna go to bed, put this online, and, you know, when I come back, probably have different ideas of what I want to do, whether that be, like, something apparel-oriented, tarot-oriented, life art-oriented, or whatnot. So, yeah. I'm gonna try to do it, but my paper cuts hurt, so. I got a paper cut right here, too. So it hurts. Alrighty, I'm going to go to beddy bye. Till next one, till next time. I'll be here. Bye. Drink water, stay hydrated. Don't drink blood, that's creepy.